Hi, this is 4 in the morning and I'm shooting a YouTube video. Okay, cue the intro. So this is going to be completely unscripted and I'm sleep deprived. So yeah, this is going to get interesting in a minute. So, I'm Dia and you're watching Reading with my Cat. So, as the name suggests, I am planning to talk about books that I read. Not with my cats. My cats are like, you know, impossible. So, yeah. So, I will be talking about the books I read. And I mostly read fantasy and a little bit of sci-fi sprinkled in and a little bit of contemporary. So yeah, if you like reading fantasy and if you want to, you know, see this face, and if you want for some reason my input on books or recommendations or whatnot, then this is the place to come. So come join us. That kind of sounded like, you know, the twins from The Shining. Come join us, Danny. Oh no, this one was different. Come join us, Danny. So yeah. Anyway, do they even say come join us, Daddy, or not Daddy? Not Daddy. Come join us, Danny. Do they even say that, or did I just make that up? Anyway. So today I'm going to talk about Howl's Moving Castle. I recently read Howl's Moving Castle last week and it was like such an amazing, fun, adventurous, wholesome story, and I just wanted to share it with the world. So yeah, if you haven't read Howl's Moving Castle, do read Howl's Moving Castle, because you know, it's just sunshine in a book. It's what I wanted the House in the Cerulean Sea to be, but it wasn't. The House in the Cerulean Sea was a big letdown for me. So I don't know like why it happened. I will be coming back to it later on. Like later on I'll make a video about why I like still haven't finished The House on the Cerulean Sea. So that will be a different thing. So today we are going to talk about just Howl's Moving Castle. And thing is, I watched the movie maybe 7 to 8 years ago when I was in college, and I really liked the movie, but I don't remember anything from the movie. So when I read the book, it was like a completely, you know, fresh kind of this thing, like fresh kind of an impression. Anyway, the book is very different from the movie, and so you know, like you need to treat the book as a different entity, you know, other than the movie, like a separate entity. So what I'm planning to do is I'm planning to watch the movie. I have watched like around 40 minutes or so of the movie, and I'm planning to compare the two. So in this video I'm not going to do that. This video is just because, you know, I was feeling really restless and I couldn't sleep, and I was like, I need to make the jump. I need to start making YouTube video. Like, doesn't matter where I'm shooting, what the quality is, what the lighting is, I just need to talk about this book, and I just need to talk about it right now. So here I am, barefaced. Thankfully, I shampooed my hair yesterday, so it's a little bit good today. Otherwise, it would have been, you know, tangles and knots and whatnot, matted hair completely. Anyway, sorry for the shaky camera. My tripod is in the other room, and I don't want to wake up my sister because yeah, it's 4 in the morning. She's going to kill me if I wake her up. Anyway, so Howl's Moving Castle, it's a story about this girl, Sophie. She is probably in her late teens. She is family of, she has two other sisters, and in the land of Ingeri, like where she's from, it's said that the first child will always fail if they try to seek their fortune. And Sophie has, her entire life she has been, you know, like resigned to her, you know, destiny. Like she is like, what is the point of going out and trying to seek my fortune if I'm going to fail? I'm the firstborn, like if I try to do anything I'll just fail. So that was really, you know, I mean, relatable, I would say. I mean, at times I feel like, you know, what is the point of even doing anything, like because we are all going to die and whatnot. So sorry for the existential crisis over there. Anyway, so Sophie gets cursed by this witch of the waste, and Sophie, I don't think I should say what kind of curse it is. Also, like everyone who has watched the movie, or like it's a known thing, but still I'm not going to say what the curse is. She gets cursed and then she goes to live with this wizard called Howl, and who also has an apprentice and a fire demon, and they live in a moving castle. So Howl's moving castle, and Howl is this, you know, movie Howl is very different from book Howl, and also movie Sophie is very different from book Sophie. In the book, Sophie is like sassy as fuck. Like she is, you know, like she gives it to people straight, and yeah, she doesn't take any bullshit from Howl. And Howl is this, oh my god, Howl is this, you know, like big drama queen, and he is always like, you know, oh, give me attention, I'm dying and stuff like that. And Sophie is like cutting up his favorite suit and whatnot to make dresses and all that, and like it's really fun. So the thing is, the story is nothing much happens. It's mostly a slice of life kind of a story, like how all these characters interact, and that's it. And the only complaint I have is that the ending felt a bit rushed, and I wanted there to be one more chapter, you know, so that the conclusion could have been a little well put together, instead of everything like just ending in a hurry. And also because I like really liked the banter and wanted, you know, another chapter of it. So that is my rambly thoughts on Howl's Moving Castle. I need to read the highlighted parts again before I, you know, make the comparison kind of a video between the movie and the book. So that's it for today. I hope you like my video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.